All protocols observed. Good morning. I consider myself to a large extent the product of Hillary Nguyen and the Weekly Review. Because I started reading the Weekly Review when I was still in high school. And thereafter, after my Form 6, then I had the chance to begin writing for the Weekly Review, especially the letters to the editor. And I did this for a long time, especially after I started doing this in Form 5. And then by the time I was in Form 6, I was doing quite a number of them. And some of them I was delivered. During that time, we used to never have typewriters. So I knew the box number of the Weekly Review off head. And we would be writing that and sending it by post, handwritten. And every week I had a letter. A few times when I came to Nairobi, I would always hand over, some of the copies. And I remember one time I've kept joking with Masharia Gaitho because I found him at a corner editing a piece. And then when I handed over, one of my, pieces, he said, "Put it on the table. If we find it, fine. If we don't, dustbin." That was Masharia. It's part of the joke we normally have with him. And I got to learn, to see a lot of the people who were at the Weekly Review. But one of the most profound things was that one time when I came in to hand over, I think I'd done two of those three pieces, and I decided to hand them over together. Then Hillary Nguyen called me. He walked out of his office, and then I saw, he was bearded, tall. And then he talked to another person I didn't know, and then asked me and gave me a pack of a number of publications, the Weekly Review and some small books, which I took back to Migori then. It was very profound, and I kept that as a memory, and I keep them in my library up to date. I keep huge copies, numbers of this in my library, and also the Makers of a Nation. The other memory I have is of reading his book, The Men from Pretoria. It was a wonderful book, frightening, by some of the things that happened. Yeah, but I just also wanted to say that around 1990-91, as a student, I think I'd graduated, we were very fiery, more or less to the left, and writing very fiery pieces. I used to see that a number of them were put the way they were with certain changes. I didn't find a lot of change that you people are making to my articles. And last month, when Philip Ochieng died, I went to my library and kept looking at them. I fished out all the letters that I keep, that I wrote in the Weekly Review and other opinion pieces. And I remembered one thing. Rose Lucalo, remember, since April 2018, is it? No, 2000. When was that? I mean, this is 2018. We have kept saying and urging all the other media, senior guys, that we need to do a lot of documentation. And that was the purpose why we had the meeting at, it was at Laico, and then we decided to have another meeting of media veterans at the Crown Plaza Hotel. It is something I would like to repeat here, that we have not documented enough about some of the senior guys who are going. And last year, when we were at Manzoni, we did also talk about this. And personally, I nursed fears because we had a discussion with the Mugambi Kiai of Article 19, when there was this PDF was circulating about Hillary. We said, okay, look, and I think we spoke to you because we're in a group. We said, how do we document a lot more? Of course, we are happy that something had been done about that. But then we had fears about Philip Ochieng. We probably need to have, we have fears about Joe Kadhi, And a while ago, before COVID came, we said, do we go and visit him? So we lose a lot of memory. So at a personal level, therefore, I would like to say that Hillary shaped my journalism and gave me a lot of space to write a lot of opinion pieces, even when I was a student. And when I came out, actually, when I was in Form 6, they announced a vacancy. They wanted an economic reporter. I hadn't done economics. I had done English and history. But I said, because I've been writing for the Weekly Review, let me go. So we went there and had an interview with Jaindi Kisero. Gaito, can you confirm he was taken? Eh? Yeah, I was in that interview. I was in that interview. Trying, you know, that kind of thing. But I want to quickly say that this remains a seminal, the Weekly Review remains a seminal, publication. And it shaped this country. Just like we're talking with Mheshimiwa Gitogwi Manyara, that the few people know that he was the founder of the Nairobi Law.